Hello, pipe fitters and engineers worldwide. Today, I'll be showing you how to create a pipe spool using our 3D piping module. Please leave us a comment below and let us know what you think after watching this tutorial, or share it with a coworker or friend. Here's what we will be doing. First, we'll create a 3D sketch. Then, we'll add some flanges and pipe. And lastly, we'll dimension the pipe spool. I'll also be working with our CAD standalone called AviCAD. But no worries, even if you're working in AutoCAD or even AutoCAD LT, we've got an add-on just for you, and the steps will be exactly the same. I've also included a bonus tutorial at the end of this video, so stay tuned. But before we get started, let's first turn on the ortho command. This will restrict our cursor in the X, Y, and Z directions. I really recommend drawing a quick 3D sketch of the routing first. This will make the model even more simple, plus you'll have a good base to start from. It's all very simple, as you will soon see. So here I'm creating a sketch by simply using the line command and then using direct distance input, as I'm showing you here. If you're wondering what direct distance is, it's really just like it sounds. For example here, I'm entering the beginning point on a line. Then I'm pointing the cursor the way I need to go, and lastly, typing in 2 feet. With ortho turned on, I can also do the same sort of input in the Z direction. In just a minute, I'll be snapping over these lines and creating my pipe spool. So now, let's load the piping routine by selecting the piping icon in our toolbar. Here, you'll see several different specs and options, but today, we're using a 4-inch butt welded fitting. We'll choose the double flange fitting, and when prompted, we'll say yes to both gasket and fastener holes. Then we'll choose a point in the upstream direction. Now for the fun part, we'll simply select a straight piece of pipe and then trace over our 3D construction lines. Notice how Mech-Q is automatically adding elbows at each turn. Now, on the back side of this run, I want to add a reducer. Let's go ahead and select the reducer from the main piping dialog. Here, you'll have the choice whether to use concentric or eccentric reducers. Let's choose a 4x3 reducer by just clicking directly on the thumbnail. Notice now how Mech-Q recognized the size of pipe that we're downsizing to, and at the same time maintaining the butt welded fitting type and material. So let's put in a straight piece here. And then to finish the run, I'll add another flange. Mech-Q recognizes we're at 3-inch and auto-selects the matching flange. See what I mean? This couldn't be any easier. Lastly, let's add a branch to the existing piping spool by selecting a 2-inch piece of pipe and then complete our drawing with a flange. Hang in there while I finish up. Okay, it's really taking shape now. Next, let's add a few dimensions to specify the lengths from centerline to centerline. To dimension, we just need to snap the piping nodes and placing the dimension where we need it. Working in 3D really isn't as hard as you may think. With just a little practice, you'll get it. To find out more about how 3D dimensions work and watch other related tutorials, please visit our video library at cadavenue.com. Now for the bonus tutorial. During the last few minutes, Mech-Q has been counting of all the parts in our piping spool. This allows us to create a bill of material schedule, or what we call BOM. First, let me check a couple of settings. Notice in the options menu, I'm turning on the bubble option. And I've also specified a dim scale of 12. Dim scale sets the sizes of the table based on the final print or plot scale. See our attached cheat sheet for more on this if you're new to CAD. Next, after running the BOM from the main piping dialog, I am asked the rotation angle of the bubble. Here, I'm choosing Z since I'm in a 3D view. Then I'm presented with a rubber band line. This isn't the leader line quite yet. Mech-Q is just letting me know which fitting I'll be bubbling. I'll just select the starting point of the leader and then the bubble location by pressing the Enter key. Hang in there, we're almost finished. Pay attention to the command prompts below. You can either skip or label each piece as I'm showing you here. Yes, this is really just as easy as it looks. You'll also have the option to place bubbles side by side by choosing the tangential option for the start point. This is real useful if labeling bolts or gaskets. By using tangential, you can simplify the drawing by only adding a bubble without a leader line, as I'm doing here. Presto! We're done! So take some time out today and try out Mech-Q. With just a little bit of practice, you too can easily draw a piping spool. To find out more about Mech-Q, visit us at cadavenue.com. A 30-day trial is also available. Send us your questions or call us at 888-271-7121. You can also reach us by email at info@cadavenue.com. YouTubers, please leave your comments, or if you're running short on time, please give us a thumbs up.